Hey there! So, we know how to create an array of us related subclasses as one class. Every class in the array is treated as a superclass. What if we wanted to go the other direction? What if we needed to know the specific class for an instance in our list? In this lesson, we're going to take a quick look at how we can determine the class of an instance. When we need to test an instance to see what class it belongs to, we can use the keyword instanceOf. This keyword acts as a binary operator. It takes an instance and a class as the two operators. The instance is any object variable, and the class is any java.lang.Class object. We provide the instance we want to test, in this case, Sprite 42. We use the keyword instanceOf, and finally, we provide the class we're testing against. In this Java instanceOf example, com.deege.sprite. This expression returns a Boolean. We'd use it in a Boolean test like this. In this code, we're testing to see if the variable sprite42 is indeed a sprite. If it is, we cast it to a new variable and do something with it. This is a common pattern you'll see when working with an instance, where you're not sure of the actual type. If we test any instance against java.lang object, we will always get true. However, if we test null against any class, including object, we will always get false. This makes sense since all classes in Java are subclasses of object, and null is not a subclass of any object. Remember, it just means nothing. This is a good thing to remember. InstanceOf operations do not need explicit null checks. If the instance you're testing is null, the code will always return false. The other way we can test is just ask the class. Every class has a method, getClass. This method is defined in the class object and returns a class called class. The bracket T stuff after the class is something we'll get to when we cover generics. You don't really need to understand it right now. GetClass will tell you the class you're working with. Once you have a class instance, you can even ask what the parent class is. The class has a method called getSuperClass. So what happens when we call getSuperClass on a class object? Well, we get null. That makes sense, since object is a top class in every hierarchy. All right, well that gives us two ways to determine the class of an instance. We can test against a known class, as we saw in the Java instanceOf example, using the instanceOf keyword, or we can just ask the object what class it is. Which method you use really depends on what you're trying to accomplish. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. If you like this video, make sure you like and share. This helps get the video in front of other viewers. New videos come out every week, so make sure you subscribe. That way you don't miss a tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.